If no common thread weaves a society together, it falls apart. In Japan's tightly woven communities, Ekiden is essential for community formation and community solidarity. Ekiden is tightly woven into Japan's national identity, into its obsession with work, and into many other unique aspects of Japanese culture. Ekiden is Japan in a nutshell. But what is it? Well, in short, it's a long-distance relay race. But the stories we'll hear reveal how Ekiden is so much more than just a sport. Let's pull one of these threads and see where it takes us. Why don't we start with the basic question? Where did Ekiden come from in the first place? Ekiden is a uniquely Japanese invention. It began in 1917 as part of the 50th anniversary celebration of the moving of Japan's capital from Kyoto to Tokyo. The Yomiuri Shimbun, a Japanese newspaper, sponsored a 508-kilometer relay race with two teams of 23 runners each, most of whom were university students. That number, 23, mirrored the 23 stages, akin to stations, or eki, that had marked the stops from Kyoto to Edo, or Tokyo. From that original birth in 1917, Ekiden-style events spread across Japan, and the best-known events of these now is Hakone Ekiden. Ekiden has been likened to a drama with a changing stage, as each race may have its own number of legs, and a spur-of-the-moment script that is constantly being rewritten. How each runner will fare on their leg is unknown. If only one runner stumbles, the whole team fails. But on the flip side, if only one runner can exceed expectations, the entire team can be pulled to glory. These ideas of teamwork, patience, discipline, duty to others, hard work, and endurance are quintessential values that Japan embraces. The name Ekiden is a combination of the characters for station, eki, and transmit, den. The term was inspired by the Tokaido method of communication in 18th century Japan. These transit stations, eki, would be set up along roads where couriers would stop for refreshments and to pass the message on to another courier. Today, the relay runners wear a sash called taski to symbolize this idea of passing something on to the other runners. Ekiden is a staple of Japanese culture today, but how did it even get like this in the first place?
There's a reason. It's a very long history. After World War II, our resident condition is very bad, which means like we are very poor and we couldn't build a house. In that time, company provided many residents for the employees, and also in 1970s, they started to provide a leisure, and one of leisure is.
On the outside, if you visit just for a short while, Japan may seem like some well-oiled machine in which everything has a place and everything does its part perfectly. But Ekiden reveals to us so many more aspects of Japanese culture which may go unnoticed. Let's continue to explore these stories to find out just why Ekiden is Japan.
Way of training when I was a kid, don't drink water. Gamma, this is a key word in Japan, gamma, like perseverance, or patience, okay? You want to drink the water, but not to drink. Then to concentrate on your job. People wanted to see, there's a water, wants to drink, but the runner don't drink. That's Japanese kind of mental kind of beauty, né? But of course harmful in the body. And the runner really dehydrate. And they lose kind of mind and consciousness. And then the camera comes in. Like, Toyo University runner is now walking, even can't run. And then, like this, né? And then for me, come on, he's gonna die, give the water. But the people, still, he's walking, not running, but aiming to the goal, that's like crazy. But people like to watch that point. And then coach also said, stand up, run, no, don't do it. Just save him's life. But runner also said, even losing the consciousness, losing the mindset, I have to run for other people, for university. And then sometimes stand up, and then people clapping hands. For me, no, not clapping hands. Just grab his body, bring him to the ambulance. That's how we have to do it. American people think that way. No, Japanese people, stand up, run, run. And he's, people waiting for this kind of terrible moment. Runner suffers, losing the mind.
In Japanese, I say pin pin korori. That means pin pin means in good shape, you know, very, very, very healthy. Korori means drop dead. That means very healthy until the very end and then drop dead in the end, all of a sudden.
You may be asking yourself, why are people going to such lengths where they're almost killing themselves just for a race? Well, to answer that, there are two words that you need to know. Honne and tatemae.
The real truth, the real thing. And tatemae is show to people, the external, show, not your real feelings, your what you want people to see.
And difficult, you know, society to live in. I don't know. Yeah. I'm Japanese, so I have to adapt, you know. But sometimes I feel like I'm an outsider. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm too straightforward. But they now accept me as I am. That's good. Yeah. Foreigners to communicate with Japanese people is not that easy, right? You have to really read between the lines, right? And okay, he's saying yes, but does he really mean yes? You know, okay, she's saying no. Okay, does she really mean that? Or does she try to be just polite to you? And this kind of sort of reading between the lines is very difficult, even for Japanese. Yeah. Right. Cheers.
Cheers.
Oh, 500 hours, Tokyo, Japan. Train engines rumble, the echoes rebounding in station tunnels. Salarymen dutifully, silently assemble in empty metro cars. The morning commute begins. In 2 hours, children will flood the sidewalks of small towns, amiably holding hands as they walk to school, unchaperoned. It is October. Hakone Ekiden is still 3 months away, but anticipation of the race lingers in the pre-dawn stillness, as university runners throughout the Tokyo prefecture lace up their shoes and jog lightly with their teammates. The scene is so picturesque. Nothing tempts a further look into the well-oiled machine of Japanese society. Harmony. Wah. Harmony is Japan. Harmony is the wandering tourist's big takeaway. Harmony, for many, is the end of the narrative. A narrative that begins with an expectation.
So one person finish like I did when I was a kid. I did it. It's okay. It's piece of cake. Finish. And the teacher comes in. No. You're not done. You have to help other kids. Your group is 5. You finish and you still have to help 4 people. You finish, that's good. But it's not end. You have to help.
On the one hand, students need to be competitive. Most of the universities have more than 50 runners, but only 10 for Ekiden. They compete with each other, but also have to support each other. The students will supervise their own meetings. They have many rules. They have to study hard, wake up before 5 a.m., breakfast, then evening, they eat together. For long distance running, eating and sleeping together are very important, like a family.
Wake up together, sleep together, even coach with them. This make a harmony. Make harmony, you can make a miracle. 1 + 1 = 2. This is mathematically correct for the Japanese things. If 10 + 2, 10 + 10, 20 people, we really become one, means 10 + 10 = 30 or even 40. So those group dynamics people trust.
Though we are united, we are one, has a very specific context that doesn't necessarily include those of us who are not actually part of that.
Only run foreign runner per team for Hakone. That is the limitation.
The restriction of the Africans to the shortest stage, I think, has a couple of different ramifications that are or reasons behind that. It's nominally to restrict the impact on teams that can't afford to have an African or that choose not to have an African. From the broadcast point of view, you know, what do Japanese people want to see? Do they want to see Japanese runners running, or do they want to see African runners thrashing the Japanese runners? And of course, they want to see Japanese runners running. And so, strictly from the business standpoint of the broadcaster, it makes sense to have them on this short stage, right? And I completely don't agree with that, but that's a big part of the rationale behind that, strictly from like their operational standpoint. If you think about like what is the message if you're a Japanese runner, especially like a young developing Japanese runner, where the old boys, the powers that be, say, you know, no, you know, these Africans are going to beat you, like that's just a given, and that's going to screw up the TV broadcast, so you're not allowed to run against them because they're going to beat you, right? And so you're getting the message, if you're a young runner, you're getting that message right from day one that they're better than you. That has had a real impact until like fairly recently. I think you can look at the period where Africans came to Japan and kind of there was to a large degree after that a decline in Japanese performances in the marathon abroad. And I think part of that is psychological. It's just like you see somebody with different color skin and boom, they're better than me.
If you talk about foreign students at Hakone, the fastest are from Kenya. From a Japanese perspective, we think that it's not fair because Kenyan people can run faster than us.
Japan is one of the least mobile countries in the world. Residentially, people tend to stay where they were born. This leads to deep roots as people invest into building communities which become their homes for life. Ekiden is one national sport that brings together all of these disparate communities and unites the nation. Hakone Ekiden alone draws an audience rating of over 33%, nearly as much as the US Super Bowl. And this isn't counting the thousands of dedicated fans lining the sidewalks as the runners race across the country. Because this race takes place over New Year's break, people are at home with their families, and Hakone is a constant background during this time. In short, Hakone is both a singular event and a shared experience that brings the people of Japan together, from all ages and all backgrounds. The sport is a microcosm of Japan in that it is inherently wedded to the Japanese identity, Japan's work culture, and other Japanese cultural values.
Unfortunately, as we saw with the many limitations placed on Kenyan runners in Hakone Ekiden, Hakone reveals the darker aspects of Japanese culture as well. And yet, Hakone Ekiden's enormous national fan base is not the only community built around Ekiden. Ekiden's unique structure, in which every runner is reliant on his or her teammates, changes running from a sport focused on the individual to a team-based communal activity. Up next, we'll see this in action with Nambon Ringo, Tokyo's oldest international running club, which was founded around the sport of Ekiden.
Started about 29 years ago when I met several foreigners, running in Japan, foreign runners, and we decided to run together. And we met some more runners, and eventually kind of evolved into a running club. So Nambon Ringo was the name was created by a Japanese friend of mine, and it means the southern barbarian. which they did. Of course, they come all the way from Portugal around. This was the original Portuguese traders. So we're the Barbarian Horde, and we meet every Wednesday night at this track. You can see it's a crowded track. Running is very popular in Japan. And we also have a group that meets on Saturday morning for a short workout. And after both of these workouts, we go to dinner. So it's a social occasion as well, not just the running and the training. And people like that. It's a very informal club. We don't have a lot of rules and regulations and officers. In fact, I'm probably the only officer. I'm the chairman of the horde. And our members like that. We also have a number of events throughout the year. For example, we have a run and barbecue in November that so far about 115 people have signed up for.
Since 2003, so it's been a long time. And great thing about Namban is open-minded atmosphere.
I mean, yeah, there's a lot of serious runners in it, but what I found out was that more importantly was just a warm community of people who were encouraging and just engaging, and it was sort of the community that I was looking for in my life in Japan. Plus, you know, I get to run, which has been a hobby of mine over the years. So that's why I'm still a member.
You know, Namban runners come in all sizes and ages and all shapes, right? And I wouldn't say I'm a first runner myself, but everybody sort of gives themselves, you know? Like everybody just push how hard they can be, but, you know, I like the attitude, I like the spirit. You know, every time I run with Namban people, I have to push myself, you know, that's what I like about them.
Namban's a great group of people. I like to show up and go for, you know, a very serious run and have a beer and hang out with people that are fun to run with and fun to have a beer with. What more do you want?
Okay, thank you all for a great turnout today.
find it difficult to meet Japanese except in their company, which is not really a friendly atmosphere. It's a work atmosphere, obviously. And even to meet other foreigners can be difficult for a lot of foreigners in Tokyo. So, and actually it's true for Japanese too. A lot of Japanese have trouble meeting people because you know how hard Japanese work. They work until 11 o'clock every night. So it's difficult to make friends. And Nanban Rengo serves that purpose for runners. You obviously have to be interested in running. But for people interested in running, it's a great way to meet other foreigners and to meet Japanese. A lot of our members really feel that that's very important in their lives in Tokyo. Very often when people leave Tokyo, they'll say to me, if it hadn't been for Nanban Rengo, you know, I wouldn't have had any Japanese friends, and I wouldn't have had friends from Ireland and France and Turkey and New Zealand, and we have foreigners from 15 or 20 different countries. A lot of our members really become good friends, become lifelong friends, and also when they move away, they will stay in touch with us. And say, if you're ever in Johannesburg, South Africa, or Bern, Switzerland, or Stockholm, Sweden, look us up. And people do, actually. Nanban Rengos will go to these places, go to either a race or just on vacation, and get in touch with the former Nanban people, which I think is great. And I think that's one of the really great aspects of this club. People become friends through running for life, really.
Yeah.